kit came from Velocity in Florida. It's a Velocity XL. We call it a Phoenix VXL because of the changes we made to the kit. We have two flight sticks in there, which is different than the regular Velocities, one on each side. And the turbine engine is something that no other Velocity has. So for different reasons, we didn't call it a Velocity. It's a Lycoming turbine, 600 horse. We got it out of air sprayer in Oklahoma. Put it through the factory, it's zero timed. The engine, we've derated it, so it's putting out 420 horse on the gauges. If you push the throttle all the way ahead, the gauges go red, but you can get the 600 horsepower. We've played around with the cowling, had different induction system. We scrapped that, we went to the NACA scoop, gained 20 knots in airspeed. It runs a lot cooler, quieter, better. The prop is MT, obviously a five blade prop, MT out of Germany, constant speed. There's no governor. The governor for the propeller is built in, runs at 1950 RPM. We don't have to adjust that, it's a constant speed. So inside all you have is a throttle and fuel shutoff. Makes it pretty easy. Not a whole lot else about the turbine. Lots of oil capacity. The oil temperature runs about 50 degrees. Doesn't matter on the outside temperature. Run two boost pumps. It's not really necessary. We have a fuel flow of about 35 gallons an hour at full power. The system is tested to 45 gallons an hour, so we have a pretty good safety margin. The plane was built by an aeronautical engineer, Franz Friesen, from Edmonton. It's the third Velocity that he's built, so he's getting pretty proficient at it. It's obviously not your standard Velocity. There's a lot of changes that had to be made, and a lot of things had to come together, and he made it happen with very little problems. He assembled the turbine, you know, from the factory, assembled the fuel system and the cooling system for the oil, and no hitches. It's a full IFR, King radios, King radio stack with King GPS, Sentry 2000 autopilot with altitude hold, radar altimeter, slaved HSI. It's all the gauges for the turbine are digital and very accurate. I don't think it lacks anything. It handles a lot better at high speed than low speed, but it's very quick and very responsive. The interior was done by Edmonton Aero Upholstery, Lawrence Poulet. It's all leather. The seats are from a 99 Corvette, brand new. The two front seats are power seats. Two back are mechanical. The airframe weighs in at just over 2,100 pounds, empty. And plus it'll hold another 600 pounds of fuel. We've licensed it for 3,000 pounds, but it'll carry a lot more than that pretty easily. The plane has oxygen for four people for 3 hours, oxygen supply. So the turbine flies a lot better at 18 to 20,000 feet. It's not a pressurized cabin, but with the oxygen on board, it's not a problem. The aircraft was started January 98 and completed in August of 2000. The first flight was around August the 10th, I think, of 2000. We're planning to take the plane to Oshkosh in 2001, and it'll be for sale in that summer. Hopefully it doesn't sell before Oshkosh. The paint is tri-coat. It was done in Edmonton. It's pearl white with a gold metal flake. Takeoff distance is about 1,000 feet with two people on board, full fuel. You can get 800 feet out of it if you really milk it, but it's easily 1,000 feet. Rate of climb is 1,500 to 2,000 feet a minute at 140 knots. And cruising speed is 200 knots indicated. And that doesn't seem to change whether it's 3,000 feet or 13,000 feet. Cruising power is at 96% power, 95-96% power, and the fuel burn there is about 30 gallons an hour at low altitudes. At 13,000 feet, it's down to about 24 gallons an hour, and should be around 20 gallons an hour at 20,000 feet, but we haven't had it that high yet. Descent, it's not a problem slowing the plane down. With the empty prop, as soon as the power is pulled back a bit, it drops fairly rapidly. The prop is very performance minded. A small increase of 1 or 2% in power and the plane just jumps ahead. The same for a decrease, it just pulls back.
Like, I would switch it to pressure for startup to make sure you have oil pressure. And once it's above 10 degrees, then run it up to 68% and then turn the generator on.
Thank you. Okay, it's recording, so we can. So come on in here, whatever. Because he's gonna laugh. He looks at me.
What, I will laugh.
What I need you to do, Mike, is I need you to talk about the power plant and instrumentation. Let's just start with one. Let's talk a little bit about the. Look at him. You don't need to look at the camera.
What do you want to talk to me or him?
You don't need to say anything. But I'd like you to...
Why is he there then?
Well, you got to talk to someone. You want me to stand there? You're just gonna start giggling if it's me. So. No, all right. Okay, so, and you're going to stick with the glasses, right?
Well, it's sunny.
Yeah, okay.
It's sunny day. What a coat.
Yeah. Okay, you need to stay still.
Okay. We're not even looking at him.
No, I'm just watching your shadow going okay. over his stomach.
Okay. Okay. So but you don't need to stand.
You don't have to stand there if you want.
Go over there and smoke.
There's no shadow, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so what do we want to say about, go ahead, philosophy. We don't have to use it, so
sure.
I'm just gonna take a quick peek. Yeah, that's really good. Makes the frame makes it look really tall.
So you're only showing my neck and head, right? The airframe was started in January of
98. Right after Oshkosh.
It couldn't have been 99. Okay. The airframe was started in January of 98. And was off and on and completed in August 4th, 1999 was the first flight. And
probably August 4th, 2000.
Oh, yeah.
So let's just start again with the aircraft was there.
There's really been no problems with it. The only problems... We're pilot. We can cut that one.
Yeah. Yeah, come over. I don't really know what I'm doing.
It weighs just over 2,100 pounds empty. Holds,
This thing picks up everything.
We haven't shown it yet, but we're hoping to win some awards with it pretty easily.
Where? You know, your plans are?
Westlock.
At no time did you mention that it was built by an aeronautical maintenance engineer?
I was getting to that. Oh. I did right. not build the plane. The France was... The France. Okay. And the striping is also painted on, and, hey, you want to put decals on? That's important.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Yeah, well.
See. I shouldn't have started laughing.
No, sorry. You shouldn't have. Okay, do you want me not to say that?
Is there any fun to fly?
Some days.
Okay, but you see, I'm going to cut my part out, so all I got was some days. Yeah. I don't know, if you ask me, it's pretty hard not to grin in the aircraft.
But. Yeah, yeah.
You could say something more about the trim.
Like what?
Is it, I don't know, is that representative of a bird, or is it just
style,
or...
Okay, see, look at the camera, yeah, there you go.
Well, it is representative of the Phoenix bird.
Oh, good job, Mike.